Hello students, next important topic of data representation chapter is binary arithmetic. Okay, so as the name indicates, already we know that what is arithmetic. It may include addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Okay, so in this session we will discuss how the two important arithmetic operation like binary addition and binary subtraction are performed inside a computer. Okay, so computers understands only zeros and ones. So that in this session we'll discuss how two important arithmetic operations such as addition and subtraction can be performed inside a computer by making use of binary numbers. Okay, so what actually binary arithmetic is much simple to learn because binary number system consists of what? Zeros and ones. So if any arithmetic operations are performed on those zeros and ones, then we are going to get output or result as zeros and ones itself. Okay, so if the input or value will be in zeros and ones, then the output or results also will be in the form of zeros and ones. Okay, so now we'll discuss what is binary addition and how to perform binary addition and how it takes place inside the computers. Because computers understands only zeros and ones, everything will be in the binary format. So that in this section we'll see what is binary addition and what is binary subtraction, how it can be done. Okay, so first now we'll see what is binary addition. So as you all know that the addition of any two binary numbers is performed in exactly same manner as of the addition of decimal numbers. Okay, so decimal number system consists of 0 to 9 values, right? So let us first review the decimal addition here. For example, I will take some number 647. I want to add so that 189. How to perform normal addition here? First we need to sum up these two values. Okay, so 9 plus 7 is what? 16. Then 6, 1 will be what? Carry, right? That will be written on the next column. Then 4 plus 8 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. So 3, carry will be what? 1. So 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. So what will be the output? 836. We are going to get 836 as a resultant. These two are the carry values, right? So the least significant digit, its position is operated on the first. So this 7 will be considered as what? Least significant digit. Okay, so this will be considered as LSD or LSB. That will be position is operated on the first. It's going to produce a sum of 7 plus 9, right? It's going to produce the result or sum of 7 plus 9, that is 16. So like this, it's going to add the value of those two decimal numbers, then resultant will be in the form of decimal values. Okay, so binary addition is also performed in the same manner as the decimal addition, but binary number system has only two digits, that is zeros and ones. Everything will be in the form of zeros and ones. Okay, so in order to perform any binary addition, we need to follow binary addition that is meant for only four entries. Okay, so now we'll see a complete table for that binary addition now. So here we can see a complete table for the binary addition. Okay, so this is very very important that you have to memorize these four values. Okay, so you can see here 0 plus 0 is what? 0. And 0 plus 1 will be 1, and 1 plus 0 is 1, then 1 plus 1 is 0 plus carry of 1 to the next higher position. This is very very important point that you have to keep it in mind. Okay, so 0 plus 0 is what? 0. 0 plus 1, if we add 0 and 1, we are going to get 1, and 1 plus 0 will be 1. Okay, so 1 plus 1 is 0 plus carry of 1. So don't apply a common arithmetic function here. So we are not going to get 1 plus 1 as a 2. So 1 plus 1 is 0 plus carry of 1 to the next higher position, that is to the next column. Okay, so now we'll perform some operations, some problems, then you can understand. Okay, so now here we can see a first problem, 1 0 0 and 1 1. Okay, so first write down these numbers, 1 0 0. Okay, then we have to write the another number as like this. From right to left you have to write. Okay, then we need to sum off these two values. So first you need to memorize this table, then you can solve these kind of problems easily. So what is 0 plus 1? What we are going to get, 0 plus 1 is nothing but 1. So that in output will be what? 1. Again 0 plus 1 will be what? 1. Okay, 1. So we are left out with nothing. So that this will be considered as what? 0. So then 1 plus 0 will be 1. Okay, so if I consider these binary values as a decimal, then also I need to get the same output or same result. So I will take this as a 4-to-1 format. Then this will be what? 4. Right? 4. Then these 2. Then 2 plus 1. That will be what? 3. So what is the value of 4 and 3? 7. If I add these two values, I am going to get 7. How 7 can be represented? This can be represented as a triple 1. Okay? So whatever the addition is done to the binary values or binary numbers, that must be satisfies the decimal values too. Okay? So now we'll take another example. 1001 and 101. So we need to perform the binary addition. Okay, so we'll see here, 1 plus 1 is what? It's not 2, it is 0, and the carry will be what? 1 to the next higher position, that is to the next column. Okay, so then this will be 1. So this is what? Carry. Okay, so 1 plus 0 is what? 1. 1 plus 0 will be 1. Then 0 plus 1 is what? 1. So 1, here we have nothing, so that this will be considered as 0. Then 1 plus 0 will be what? 1. Okay, so if I consider these two values as a decimal, then here we have 4 values, then I must go with 8421 format. Okay, if I add these two values, then it becomes what? 9. Right? Then so in 4 we have 1 and in 1 we have 1 position, so that 4 plus 1 is what? 5. So what is the value of 9 plus 5? That is 14. Right? How can we represent 14 in binary? So if I have taken 8421, 8 plus 4 plus 2, 12, then 12 plus 2 will be what? 14. Okay, so we can cross check the binary values or binary result with the decimal values. Okay, this is how we can do binary addition with the binary values. We are going to get the output or result as a zeros and ones only, because we have fed the input as binary values. Okay, so now we'll see another example. So before that we need to give the base for results. Okay, so whatever the value which is given in the binary format, then we need to add the radix or base of 2 to every results. Okay, so now we'll see an example. So here we have a problem of add the following binary numbers. Okay, so here we have two binary digits, then that needs to be sum up. Okay, so as the rule, 1 plus 1 is what? So we need to perform the binary addition here. So 1 plus 1 will be 0, then carry will be what? 1. Okay, then in this condition, now we need to sum up the two values first. Initial two values, then 1 plus 0. So what is the value of 1 plus 0? 1. Okay, we are going to get the result 1. Then 1 plus 1 will become 0. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then 1 plus 1 is what? 0, carry 1, and 0 plus 0 is 0. Right? Then 1 plus 0 is what? 1. Then again 1 plus 1 will be 1. Sorry, 1 plus 1 will be 0 and carry 1. Okay? Then, so in this condition we have 1 plus 1 plus 1. So what we have to do? First we need to sum up these two values. Then 1 plus 1 becomes 0. Again we need to sum up this 0 with this 1. Then we are going to get 1. Okay, so that 1 plus 1 will be 0, carry 1, then 0 plus 1 will be what? 1. Okay, so and this carry has left out with no values, so that write as it is. Okay, then we need to give the radix or base to this values. So the result will be what? 11 00 00. Okay, that. Then don't forget to write this radix or base value. This is very very important. So what if we have a fractional part? So in case binary integer is again same as for the ordinary decimal numbers too. Okay, so we'll see that kind of problem now. 1011 00 00 and 1101. Okay, so first what we have to do, first we write the problem. Okay, so ithara problem irbekadre en madbeko, first n value kottirtare write as it is. Okay, that is 1011 binary point plus 011. Okay, so this is the first binary number. Then we need to write the second binary number from right to left. Okay, so write from right to left. So that 111, put a binary point because we have a binary point here. Okay, and write these four values 1 0 1 1 from right to left. You have to take. Okay, then now we'll perform a binary addition. So 1 plus 1 is what? 0, carry 1. So that 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then again 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, then 1 plus 0 is 1. Then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. And put a binary point as it is. Okay, then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then 0 plus 0 will be 0. 1 plus 0 will be 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. So here 0, carry 1. Then 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Then that 0 plus 1 is 1. So we are left out with nothing. So that write as it is. So what is the result now? 11 00 01 binary point with 010. So what will be the base or radix? 2, because we are dealing with binary value. Then how to write the resultant? 1 0 1 1 0 11 and another number is 1 1 0 1. Okay, so give a base for each value, then the resultant will be what? 1 0 0 1. So here we have, and then 010. Base or radix is 2. Okay, so this is regarding binary addition. So you have to keep it in mind this 4 values. Okay, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, and 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1 to the next higher position, that is to the next column. Okay, thank you.